Chamber group is going to be a trombone tenor sax group, and they're going to perform a piece called Shaboom. Okay, so they're going to go ahead and come on out here. I will say this, what's really cool about these chamber groups is I really didn't have much to do with it. I always love when students can get together and play music, and so Ashlyn came up, found that solo on her own. These guys found this piece, and they've been working on it with little help from me, and so it's really cool to see them do this, because it just shows that they can do things on their own without me having to stand over them. So you're in for a real treat. This is Shaboom.
Thank you.
All right, and so our last piece is going to be Vertical River, which is a marimba and vibraphone duet performed by Ashlyn and Keely. So hope you enjoy. So we're going to make a quick transition to our jazz band. We've got two tunes for you tonight, and we're going to just kind of tune up and warm up for a second, and then we'll come right back. All right, so the first tune we're going to play with our Jazzy Dragon Jazz Band is going to be All Star, and it's going to feature, tonight you're just in for a real treat. We're going to feature a lot of students doing some improv, and so each of these two tunes have some extensive improv solos that are going to happen. So we've got 10 students that are going to improv on this first tune, and we got 15 students on the second one. So you're in for a real treat. Just a couple of things on when someone solos, it's totally okay to clap. It's okay to whoop whoop. It's gonna go, yeah, that's my kid. Again, it helps feed the energy into what we do, okay? So the first tune we're gonna play is All Star. Thank you.
Thank you.
that was Lillian, Hayden, Isabella, Daniel, David, Jacob, Gavin, Matt, Caleb, and Sophia. Let's give it up one more time for all those solos. All right, so I'm gonna pause for a second before we play our last tune. We have a couple of seniors in this ensemble that I wanna recognize. Some of these students are not in our concert band, so I'll recognize those seniors in a minute, but looks like David Carroll, stand up for us. This is David Carroll. He is a senior. David will be attending Tennessee Tech University with a major in physics, so we're really proud of him. Glad that he's being able to be a part of our group. So our last tune is one that I just love to play. It's a great song. It's a really great jazz standard. The students love it. It also gives them a lot of opportunities to improv and solo. So this one, we bumped up to 15 solos, but it's just really cool. I wanna just take a moment. I told this in the class the other day. I said, how many people improv at the beginning of the semester? And it was like, I was seeing 3, 2, 5. That's how many people would do it in class, like voluntarily. And so when I see, you know, we have over 20 people doing improv solos tonight. Some of them, this is their first time doing it in front of a crowd. You know, at the beginning of the semester, they, yeah, give it up for that. You know, they wouldn't do it in class, and then they said, hey, last concert, I want to do it. And so it's really cool. It's a skill that it takes time to develop. We had Isaac Riston in last week, who's a bass player, 2-time Grammy Award-winning bass player right here in Clinton, Tennessee, and he came out and talked to our students about just the life of a musician, like a gigging musician. He goes back and forth between Nashville here, talking about improv, and just a really cool guy. And so I hope to have him out more, but I think he was really inspirational to our students, and so just very fortunate to have those kind of opportunities. So enough of me yapping, here is the chicken.
Thank you. Thank you.
up for Lillian Hayden, Isabella Trey, Emily, Sarah, Daniel, David, Gavin, Matt, Caleb, Ethan, and Sophie on those solos. Give it up for this jazz band, everybody. And Seth, and Gavin. Sorry, forgot them. And Seth and Gavin. All right, we're gonna make a quick transition, and then we're gonna get with our percussion ensemble. All right. We are very fortunate here at Clinton High School to have some exceptional staff that get to come in and work with us. And our percussion instructor, Zach Elgin, is one of those people. Zach gets to come out 3 days a week. He helps me out with the band, helps me out with percussion, and then he also gets to work with our percussion students on some percussion ensemble. So you're in for a real treat. They got two tunes. The first one is called Low Tide, and then the second one is called Mercury Rising. So please enjoy our professional ensemble. Thank you. So we're into our final installment for tonight. Okay, so as the percussion is moving back over, we're gonna warm up and then be ready to come with our concert band performance.
Thank you.
that went exactly how I planned it. Just kidding. The next piece we're going to do is The Great Locomotive Chase. So it's about two trains, and you're going to hear a lot of different sounds, a lot of high energy, so hope you enjoy this one.
Thank you.
Typically, I like to always play a march in the spring. We focus so heavily on marching band in the fall, and then we work on concert festival music when we go to that. Marches are kind of a staple of the wind band literature. So tonight, we're going to play the Thunderer March, and we hope you enjoy. Before we play our last piece, I just want to say a couple quick thank yous, and then I want to highlight our senior class of 2023. First of all, we have a ton of sponsors that are able to help provide funds for us to do what we do, so I want to just thank these people, Ethan and Michaela French, CHS Band Class of 94, Stan Markham, Pat Braden, Jeff Wyrick, Frank Underwood, Robert Jamison, Phil and Effie Tipton, Joey Smith, Sellers Realty, Jim and Cheryl Hunter, Legends of Mint Photography, Bob and Leisha Bounty, Philip and Jana James, Memorial United Methodist Church, Brute Performance, First Baptist Church, Clinton, Hoskins Drugstore, Performance Truck, Incorporated, and Tim and Billy Powers. Let's give it up for those people. Uh, also just want to say, we have some of the most supportive staff members and admin that I could ever ask for. They were here 2 hours before. I got to give it up for our AD, Nate Martin, one of our ADs. He was here trying to get those bleachers pulled out. He was on his stomach trying to mess with electrical, like sweating like crazy. And so, again, I don't know if he's here tonight, but just thank you to Nate, also to Coach Lockhart, who came. Again, who has a lot of stuff going on at home, and he came and tried to help. Just thank you to our admin, thank you to you parents, thank you to the students, thank you to the county. Again, it's unheard of the kinds of funds that we get to be able to do what we do, and it's not like this everywhere. So I'm very, very blessed to be able to stand in front of your students every day to teach. And so, and also just gotta thank my wife, who couldn't be here tonight with our boys. You know, she is the glue to our relationship. Without her, I couldn't really do any of this too. So I just want to publicly thank her for that. So now let's get to our students. So when I call these students' names, I want to ask them to stand up. These are students that, if I believe correctly, when I was hired here 6 years ago, I was the assistant at the middle school, and or I was the Clint Middle School band director and assistant here. I think these guys were in seventh grade. And so they got me fresh out of school. And it's truly been an honor to watch them grow. What's crazy is, I guess I feel like I'm getting older, because again, these kids have been in the band program now for, at least under me, for 6 years. And so, first person I want to highlight is Matt Chisholm. Matt is a horn, trumpet, and mellophone player. Matt's going to go to Pellissippi State Community College for a couple years. He wants to major in communications and media. They'll continue to play through their concert and jazz band. You can stay standing. Caleb Bodinger. Caleb is a horn, trumpet, mellophone, and he was one of our drum majors this past fall. He plans to attend Pellissippi State Community College and transfer to Tennessee Tech to become a lawyer in criminal justice. Ashlyn Smith is already standing, but she is back here in the back. Ashlyn plans to attend Davidson College with her Questbridge scholarship and later transfer to a graduate school. She's currently undecided in her major, but she will continue to play music throughout her college career. I almost don't recognize this next person. He got a haircut recently. Jimmy Smallwood. Jimmy is a trumpet player. His immediate plans after high school are to serve in the United States Army. He is on, let's give it up for him. He is on contract for 3 years in active duty service. He'll be going to Fort Sill, Oklahoma for his training, which is around 3.5 months. Then he'll go to South Korea for his first duty station, which will last 1 year. He chose this because it will pay for college, pay his college off, as well as several other benefits that the military provides. Thank you, Jimmy, for your service. And the last person is Michael Batchelor. Michael is a trombone player. He plans to go to University of Tennessee, Knoxville, go Vols, and major in computer engineering. Let's give it up for Michael. So let's give it one big round of applause for the class of 2023. And I just want to take, I know I'm trying not to run long. I sat down, thank you guys, you can have a seat. I sat down just the other day and was thinking, man, what all have we done? What have we done this semester? Because I feel like if we don't ever reflect on it, we never know. It's just one thing and then another. So I just want to highlight really quickly the things that we did this summer, just so you guys know just how amazing your students are. So I'm going to praise them publicly in front of you, okay? Because they don't always get that. And I want them to hear just everything we've done. So we had students participate and make the ETSBOA Jazz Clinic in January. We had students participate and make the ETSBOA Senior Clinic. We have the best Barry sax player in the state of Tennessee for 9-10, Isabella Rice. We played multiple pep band performances at basketball games. The concert band, this group in front of you, went to the University of Tennessee's first ever volunteer clinic. The concert band received a superior rating at the ETSBOA concert assessment. It's been about 6 years since that's happened, and these guys did that. So let's give a round of applause for that. The jazz band you heard earlier performed at the DKG Pi chapter meeting in April. The jazz band has also performed at the Mosaic Arts Festival. A group of students are gonna go with me to Dollywood this Saturday, and we're gonna play at the Music in the Parks Festival. The jazz band has a run out to Clinton Elementary in a couple weeks that we're gonna do. The band's gonna play at graduation this week. We have students in AP classes, we have students in honors classes, we have multiple sports represented in our ensembles. I have students playing multiple instruments. If you notice, some people just kept going from ensemble to ensemble and they're changing things and instruments. It's amazing. We have students playing in multiple ensembles. We have students in clubs and organizations throughout this building other than just band. It's pretty friggin' amazing, if you ask me. So let's give it up for that. And without further ado, this is our last piece. Afterwards, we just have to get everything back. So again, thank you for being here. Again, thanks for supporting music education. Thanks for supporting your students. We're gonna play one final piece, and it's called Spitfire. You might wanna hold on to your seats. Thank you.
Thank you.